It's a scene you never expect to experience firsthand, a crash landing. Though it became a reality this morning for 128 passengers and crew aboard Fly Jamaica flight OJ256, destined for Toronto. Serious hydraulic issues led to the plane having to turn around and head back to Chetty-Jagan International Airport near the Guyanese capital of Georgetown, where it skidded off the runway, through a fence, coming to a stop just before dropping into a valley. 82 Canadians were on board the flight. Amazingly, everyone survived, with only 6 people suffering minor injuries. City News has learned one of the injured is an elderly Toronto woman suffering from high blood pressure and back pain. Good evening, I'm Adrian Ghobrial. The Boeing 757 was supposed to arrive here at Pearson's Terminal 3 around 7:30 this morning. I spoke with multiple passengers on board the flight. They say it was actually delayed taking off. There was maintenance crews for about 30 to 40 minutes struggling to get the front left door of the plane to close properly. They then tell me shortly after it took off, it became apparent something was seriously wrong with the plane.
I felt that the plane was not acting very stable because the engines were making a funny noise, plus the fact that the plane was waving like it was, the hydraulics was not working properly. I travel a lot on planes, so I sense when things are not right. This went on for about 10 minutes, and the plane was coming, climbing and then dropping, climbing and dropping. And then he said, we have a problem with the hydraulics. We have to return to the airport.
We overshot the runway and went into these big, large spike particles. A lot of spot, concrete spike, and it burst about 2 or 3 tires. And the plane shifted to the right, or swerved to the right, and the right wing was flapping so much it actually ripped away from the fuselage. And the engine on that right side actually turned 90 degrees upwards. And we went through a fence, and the fence actually stopped us from going over to a cliff. And 10 more feet, we'll be down 30, 40 feet in a cliff.
So everybody was jumping out the plane. They didn't want to blow up the way how the plane landed. There was smoke in the plane, so everybody was freaking out, started jumping out the emergency chute, and that's what happened.
I was shaking and really had my nervous breakdown. I was like, oh, my God. I had goosebumps all over. It was really bad.
An hydraulic issue on a plane can impact everything from the doors closing to the retraction of the landing gear.
The only time it would become a serious problem would be if you had a complete loss of hydraulics, where you went into what we call a manual reversion, where you'd lost all the hydraulics to your flight control system. And a manual reversion would present a very serious problem coming back. You can have a bad landing, and you're not going to end up like these guys here ended up. You can have a hard landing and still not end up like this. So this in itself is telling me that he had something else going on here.
What's going through your mind as you're thinking this plane might crash?
I said, I put a prayer that we'll get back. Not me, but all of us will get back safely. But it's only now I'm feeling the effects of it, you know, how close I was to death, you know. We all were to death. You know, it's almost like surreal, you know. You don't think about it at the time.
Everyone I spoke with today, obviously happy to be safe and sound. Many praising the efforts of the pilot, though their relief is quickly turning to frustration. They've yet to hear from Fly Jamaica about when they'll be able to catch another plane to Toronto. They also tell me that they've had issues getting their bags. One person I just heard from says he just got his bags. He looked inside. He was missing about $1,000, as well as his iPhone and other valuables.